We would be discussing a very relevant topic, which is not today, but right from time immemorial. But high time that we discuss it out and something is done on this issue and this area. Recently, a judgment came from Supreme Court, written by Justice Ramana, two judges bench, where Justice Ramana has spoken about the necessity of fixing notional income of the homemakers for the purpose of determination of, but that was a case of motor accident claims. So a necessity to fix the notional income to determine the compensation amount. But here we are really not concerned with that notional income to be fixed, a non-existing figure to be fixed. We are right now today. Who to be paid? Who would be paid? Whether it is by whoever, what should be the criteria? Can it be based on allocation? Can it be based on? We had a discussion. If you all of you remember, Arneshwar sir has raised this point, and we had a very we all were not in agreement of the concept which he initiated. And today also, we most of us may not be on the same page when it comes to, can you determine the income based on what all I do as a homemaker, based on the, you know, itemize the work done and then to rate it or to fix it or to determine it. But there has to be some criteria. Now, should whether it is a good idea, really, I was doing research for today's session and I realized that so many women group actually oppose this also. They say this is a regressive idea. You are reducing a homemaker to a paid worker then. And if so, the point is, what should be the criteria? So many women organizations say this is regressive. Even the men's organizations say that then you are turning the relationship into a relationship employer and employee. If you ask me to pay as a husband, then I am entitled to rate your services and then to find fault into it. And why not even to fire you out when you are not doing a good job? I'm just putting up, you know, the various points across for you all to develop. You would be glad to know that in 2012 itself, the Ministry of Women and Child Welfare, they came out with this idea of women to be paid. And in fact, they said that time the ministry was working on the idea, mulling over the concept of the husband to share a portion of his income towards his wife. They then asked for suggestions and all of the day, discussing on it. Nobody it's not as if the relationship is turned into an employer-employee relationship. Also think over when we all discussing, I hope one of you really throw light on this aspect also, that what whether the status of the woman be improved if you pay for the work done at home. And is it good idea to call it as a payment if it has to be done by the husband? I am breaching the line. I don't want to come in again. So I am just putting up my things, that to me, it would be good if we approach government, if we approach for come out and a policy to be made, but for what? And this for what may be something we would be discussing forth. Whether the government should be asked to pay, which is also a proposal by many organizations, that why not government come out with as a welfare scheme and fix some income. If fix some income based on what? That I believe we all would be discussing, that what all can be the criterias. Can husband income be a criteria? Can husband status be a criteria all alone? Would it be a good idea if I say I am an educated person, I am graduate, I am doing this ABCD XYZ work, my husband's income is this, all three should be taken as inclusive criterias. Husband to pay or only the government to pay? If husband to pay, then what share? Should it not be equal 50-50 of both? Should it not be that what all are my household expenses, including house rent, or maybe if not house rent, the property tax, if this is own house, property tax plus some other amount we add in for the house thing, and then after deducting all the expenses, then from the income left, some portion to be culled out for wife security. My concern is security aspect, and which we keep discussing also, that you know, when the wife is in marriage, husband is alive, wife is in marriage, then what is the status of the wife on economic aspect, on the financial aspect, the funds, and husband is no more, and then what is the status of the funds if the wife is getting divorced? My concern is that funds in hand. So I'm just leaving it open for all. If time is left, I can add into. Otherwise, we'll discuss, we'll exchange views. Once everybody is done, I'll request everybody to try to finish by within 5 minutes. And then we can do the cross questions. We'll go by list. And Sister Jessie, welcome to you. Welcome on the forum. And please open with your
So good evening to all. Namaskar. It's nice to see you, all the empowered women of this country here. The most empowered women are Supreme Court women lawyers. I am sure some men are there. We are today discussing mainly about women. So when we speak about this notional income, I say something permanent income. I am for it. First of all, I am speaking for it. And let us not think about the empowered women of Supreme Court or women who can earn, who are employed, who are earning. But I am mainly speaking about, my primary concern is the common women of this country who are deprived of their maintenance at home. Many women, their husbands are highly placed. They are earning good amount of income, but the woman is deprived of her maintenance. Of course, you may say, food is given. That also, without proper digestion, proper appetite, she is eating. Because always the bone of contention of the fight in the family is, I am earning, you are not earning. You are eating, you are sitting and eating. It's after my study of so many households, I have taken up this issue. And this issue is in my heart from last many years. Now, since the Supreme Court also has come out with this, I am so much encouraged. That's why I am here. So with this background, let us see this. I know even retired military fellows, their wives, they have cried before me. Doctors' wives, then highly placed railway officers' wives. They say, my husband is earning, but I don't have one pie. If I have to go out with my friends, if I have to purchase something, even to dye my hair, or to buy a sari, or to something, or go for a function, I don't have money. I have to depend upon him. And my husband does not give me. I know many women told me, still they are getting their kapda, their clothes or sari or things from their brother. From their brothers or from friends or from some relatives, or they are not buying, they are going on with the old ones. Even highly placed men's wives are speaking about them. So in such a situation, the other one is their work, untiring work day and night is not recognized by their family members, even their children. One example article I mentioned, in short I tell you, when we ask little children, that time I asked a first class boy, a boy in first class, what is your father? My father is a bank manager. What's your mother? He showed me like this, nothing. I was so shocked, mother is not doing anything. And I asked, who bathed you, who washed your clothes, who prepared your food, who cleans the house, who looks after your little brother? 100 questions. For all, he had only one answer, his mother. My mother, mom, mom, mom. Then I said, how can you say that your mother is not doing anything? Yes, she is doing everything. Then he ran to his classroom. See the mental development, how psychologically and mentally we prepare our generations that women are not doing, mother is not doing anything. Now, suppose she gets some income for her maintenance. I will not say it should be a salary, 12,000, 18,000, nothing of that sort. Now we have widow pension, we have senior citizens pension, some amount. The same way, some amount for them. I'm not saying for the maintenance of the whole house, that a man has to look after the family. Now, I am coming to who is a homemaker. All of us know from that judgment, one who is taking care of the house. According to me, homemaker must be a woman, not a man. I don't want to say it is a neutral one. I am not for it. Why? Because in Urmila Devi versus Harish Prakash, I made so many judgments. Supreme Court said, an able-bodied man should look after. If he is not able-bodied, we will say something. Now let us see. If a woman is working outside, she is employed, but the man is not employed. Let's see. Will he do the works which a woman does at home? The Supreme Court says, homemaker often prepares food for the entire family, manages the procurement of groceries and other household shopping needs, cleans and manages the house and its surroundings, undertakes decoration, repairs and maintenance work, looks after the needs of the children, including feeding, bathing, washing their clothes. Will a man do all this? If an employed woman, I say, she has to do this. She is an employee as well as she is a homemaker. She has to do everything and she has to go. I know my sister-in-law, she's a nurse. She does everything at home and she goes. She comes back and she does the work. Two children are there. Husband, he's an officer. He goes. I know what he does. So many houses, it is the same. We cannot say. At night also. Will a man spend sleepless nights with the children? The wife has to, if little ones are there. So it's in that way, I say homemaker is a woman. The next one, why a woman become homemaker? That also is very important. Women become homemakers often against their will and interest. Will and interest. She will agree, but will and interest. Even professionally well-qualified women become homemakers because of the compelled circumstances. Like after the marriage, not allowed to go for employment. After the child bearing, she has to take care of her children or look after a sick member of the matrimonial home, etc. Under such circumstances, despite her qualification or unemployment, she held before marriage. She sacrifices everything for the well-being of the family. However, the third status is not recognized. A woman spends her physical and mental energy for home building. The only sector where there is no fixed working hours is home sector, where the homemaker works day and night. She organizes everything, but she is not under organized sector. Second one, why she needs some income permanently. I have already explained that one. In many houses, I am working, that superiority complex. I am working, you are not working. You are not earning, you are sitting and eating. But whole day and night, she is maintaining that household, her children. It's because of her, he is peacefully going to office. He is peacefully going to work, but that is not recognized. That's why money matters, of course. Something earning matters in the society, in the family. It's a prestige issue also. Then, one thing, the bias of the government, let us see. That's why I want women to have some income. The bias of homemakers is shockingly prevalent. In the census of 2001, it appears that those who are doing household duties like cooking, cleaning of utensils, looking after children, fetching water, collecting firewood, have been categorized as non-workers. As a result of such a categorization, about 36 crores women in India have been classified in the census as non-workers and placed in the category of beggars, prostitutes, and prisoners. So imagine, my mother belongs to prostitutes category, prisoners category, beggars category. Many of my cousins, I am just speaking about mine, many women who are highly qualified, compelled to remain at home as homemaker, is put in the category of prisoners, prostitutes, and beggars. This is what government of India does. So we must fight against this, I say. They should not be put in this category. Our mothers, our sisters should not be put in this category. Hence, it is high time that the government introduced a policy that the homemakers will be entitled to reasonable monthly income in order to live with the human dignity. Now, will monthly income discourage women from paid work? One article I saw in the Women of India in the WhatsApp group. Good one. We have to think about. Then how we have to go about? Will monthly income diminish women's literacy in India also? Education, especially higher education, because in villages and all, they say they are educating the women to get some income after marriage. Now they know after the marriage, she will become a homemaker. She will be getting some money from the government. Then why to send her for education? That is also, when we plan this, we have to keep in mind. Then someone said husband sharing his income. There should be a law to that effect otherwise. That can be well furnished in the public sector. Means if government employee, then he has to pay this much amount or keep aside this much amount for the wife monthly. Not half, and all. I don't say half because he has to maintain the house actually, economically. But some amount. That is okay. Then husband's income cannot be the criteria. I will not agree that. Husband's income. Because many husbands are not giving to the wife for her maintenance. This is what all I want to say about this. So thank you very much for your patient listening. I am waiting to hear you all. Thank you.
I'm sorry, I was muted. Thank you, Jesse. Thank you so much.
Have you heard, Shobha, what I spoke there?
Yes, yes. I'm so sorry. Yes. I was saying something, but I was muted. Thank you so much. You spoke well. And we would be in a better position to understand all the issues and to add into.
Now, let's all speak, then we will come to conclusion.
Yes. One by one. Madhu, next is you. Madhu ma'am?
Yes. Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
You can see me also. So I know this is, there are so many speakers and this judgment has been widely discussed and they have touched every point and described what is the homemaker is. and how do they contribute to the in the family, which can be calculated as per contributions towards their income, because by which they, the way the Justice Ramanna has discussed, they have, he has calculated how they contribute, and also how it can be quantified in terms of money also. World Economic Forum in 2012 also quantified that even if 6 hours of work comes to around 45,000 rupees per month in a household family, where they, when you pay for the tuition, that work is done by a woman and everything. But all those, these points are going to be discussed in this forum. So I am going to bring some points which maybe remain untouched. The thing is that we are discussing about the women who are not earning and devoting their time totally to the family. But personally speaking, I know many, many women who are earning, but they do not have access to their money. If you go to the lowest strata of the society, you will see that like our maids, our household workers, who keep on working at home in double shift, as well as and earning the money. But when it comes to their priority, they do not have their access to their own money, which they have worked and earned from their hard work. That is very sad. And also in middle class family also, many women, they do not have access to money, whether they're working and whether they're not working also. Even if they're working, they have to work doubly. As we know, as a lawyers, Jesse Kurian was telling that we are all Supreme Court lawyers, but we know the reality as a woman lawyer also. When women lawyers are working inside the court, they have to go back and work at home and look after the tuitions and the study of their child, as well as kitchen and everything. So, but still, I know personally speaking, and there are data about that, they do not have access to their own money, which they have earned. So I want to really bring that point, whether these points are very important, because those people, by earning also, if they are deprived, whether a legislation should be brought about access to their money or access to their husband's income also. Because when some accident happens or divorce happens, many times women do not have their access to their own money also. Because we have known with our, as a lawyer experience, when we go to, for a divorce court, and when we go to the divorce and we have to get our sridhan also, or whatever maintenance also, we have to fight a lot of cases, file all the cases to get that legitimate amount of money which we are supposed to get. So in that situation, I would like to bring this point also. In that situation also, the access to money is the basic right, which brings a dignity to a woman, and to dignity and self-respect to a woman also. And even while working or non-working, they are deprived of the money, and they do not have the access of the money, which is, I don't think, is proper. And it should be recognized by government, and legislation should be brought about that. And it should be calculated in the amount of work which they are putting in the home also, according to that. And it should be paid. I'm also against this concept of paid by husband, because it will increase the patriarchy in the family, because if they start paying as a salary, they will start treating as a worker. But I am not averse to the idea, which can be discussed more in these types of forum, about government bringing a legislation of like a green yojana or something like that. The women who are working outside and inside the home, they should be paid by government a notional amount for their contributions to the society as well as at home. And this will bring the dignity and self-respect to any working woman. The third point which I would like to bring quickly is that those many times women who are working they have to leave their job because they have to raise the children. And that loss of income is not compensated by the money. And if averagely we see that on an average, a contribution of a woman is 299 minutes versus 97 minutes per day in home contribution. When they leave their job, whether the loss of income is being compensated by the family.
I'm seeing ways of doing is, one is government, as Bobbyji was saying, or Sharon ma'am was saying, to have a scheme. As she said, Grihini Yojana or some Yojana like that. Or we have a mandatory provision of some joint account to be opened at the time of marriage and some amount to pull in each month, recurring. We can have, account only to be operated by women, some amount. Yeah, I'll just complete with, I'm just putting up the suggestion so that the discussion can come in.
And one is the concept of income. 6 o'clock.
Security has to be there, as Sharon ma'am was saying, the woman in marriage does not find a financial security even to meet out her expenses. If she is not a working woman herself, but putting up a hard labor to run the home. Two, even sometimes when the marriage breaks upon, she is completely, recently I was interacting with one woman. She is married to a well-to-do family. She is she is like 16 years of marriage. She wants to now part ways because of the impossible circumstances. She says, today if I have to leave, I have not a single penny with me. So if she continues in the same household, she is in a well-to-do family. She is an educated woman, but she was not allowed to work. If she wants to leave today with her son, she does not know where to go. She is living under the risk of being molested, raped by her father-in-law. She is being attacked by her father-in-law twice or thrice. She says, now I'm getting suffocated. Right now she has got fractured her leg. So she is incapacitated also. She says, if today want to go out, I have no financial support, no roof on my head. Now, when we talk of these circumstances, we know if the husband dies, suddenly the wife comes to a halt, to a zero, back to the square one. We are talking those instances, and even like Sharon ma'am was mentioning, the working women do not have access to their money. I had direct example of our Supreme Court women lawyers.
Shobha, up to 6 o'clock.
Working women do not have the access of their money. But point is, if you are not working and dependent upon your husband's income, then should not there be a security, and by whom? By the husband or by the government? Please. And then Ritu might be adding something.
Shobha, anybody is there to speak again? Anybody?
No, you see, then Ritu is going to add something.
Yeah, up to 6 o'clock, we said 6 o'clock I will be leaving.
We are going to finish here.
Because I have some other serious matter also. I am just leaving. So Ritu is the last speaker.
Ritu has spoken, we are just discussing.
Or anybody else?
Yeah. No, speakers are done. We are now.
Means anybody else?
I just wanted to add one thing, that if we are thinking that the government is going to decide about this thing, that's a very good suggestion. But having a joint account is not going to solve anything, because as such, even if joint account is there, he will never allow to take out the money. So should be separate account, and it should, you remember Chandra Singh matter, which was decided when it was decided that the no income no income people are there, then how the money should be considered 15,000 rupees for those no income group? In the same manner, government should decide, and in that time, second schedule was introduced in 1994 due to that judgment. In the same manner, government should introduce something mandatory that you have to deposit this much of amount and she will be only able to handle it. And the, every month he should deposit the amount for the wife, for which there should be also check and balance by the government only. Then only it can be taken care of, else nothing can be changed.
According to me, if husband has to give money, again patriarchal mind will increase and women will suffer. So government must bring out a policy, a social security scheme, where women will be covered by the government. That's what I am working for.
Jesse, just clarify me one thing. And that's, I am posing a question as devil's advocate. That if you say that government should pay some income or maybe some monthly stipend to be fixed, to be paid to a homemaker's account, then who is this homemaker? Would that working woman who is also working at home, she would not be benefited with that, or every single woman would have to be benefited with that?
See, of course, government will not include the women who are employed. We just can't ask also that, isn't it? Right now, we cannot ask because they are working. We have to see people, those who are not working, women, those who are not working, sure. And we have to also see the qualification. Suppose after a degree or after skilled degree or a skilled qualification, she just stays. We have to see that.
I'm sorry, Jesse. It is not going to work because you see, when you go to America and then if the female, if the wives, they ask for the maintenance, it hardly matters whether they are working or not working. They get 50% of everything, whatever the man has. This is the rule. So why not in India? Whether we are working or not working, the moment you get married, there should be law that you should give half of the things to your wife. After all, she is only taking care of everything. Even if something is required, what we are doing, if our child, he needs or she needs something, it is the always the mother who looks for the things. Not the father. He does not even have any idea. I myself,
his mother is IAS officer working.